folks. My grandson Skyler started up a YouTube channel, and he's been on me to put more videos on mine. So I thought today I'd do a little run through on that Matco cart there that I have in the garage attached to the house. Just to kind of get you up to speed, this is a pretty big garage, but all the real work, heavy stuff, welding, fabrication, teardowns, all happens out there in that shed. However, the floor out there is not all that great. So I started doing oil changes, brake jobs, that sort of thing in here because I have nice flat concrete to work on. So when it came time to start storing some tools in here, so I wasn't going back and forth, I had planned to go back out to Harbor Freight and get another one of their service carts. However, since I bought my service cart several years ago for about $179, they have went up nearly $100, pushing $300. So I got to looking on Marketplace and found that for a couple hundred more, if you get a good deal, you can get way more cart. Now, these things are super expensive, at least to me as a garage mechanic, you know, just shade treeing. That's a ridiculous thing to have, to tell you the truth. But if you find them used, not so ridiculous, especially since all the China stuff is going through the roof. I've got probably, I did a little trading plus a little cash, but all in, I've probably got $550 in this cart. Bare, of course. But boy, comparable, well, there is no comparison. That Harbor Freight cart is great, but it ain't got nothing on this. So anyway, around here, that's actually got a bunch of junk on it, but it's what I usually use to carry detailing stuff around whenever I'm waxing or doing a paint correction on the cars. This little thing here, depending on what I'm doing, you just come up here and load it, whatever you happen to be using, and then you don't have to push the cart around to carry your polishes and whatnot. These little deals here are Rubbermaid. Pretty cheap. I mean, they're not exactly, hell, they're mostly plastic, but for what I use them for, they worked out great out here. The cabinets, the shelves, the wall hangers, all of that is all Rubbermaid stuff. Very reasonable price, and it works fine. This, I know somebody will ask, so that little setup is from Carlisle. It's basically an oil funnel, but it has adapters for all the different makes that lock into the oil fill cap, so you can dump oil in using that thing. I love it. All right, back to the cart. On the top level, I've got some magnets broken down here to hold all my ratchets and extensions. I don't have any half-inch stuff in this box because, like I said, the heavy work goes up there in the shop anyway. This just lives here, but it also works good for lighting the box up. That is a Vim Tools magnetic bit holder. All my socket rails here are Westling machine. They're great if you leave the holders in the boxes, not so great if you want to take them to your work. That mag rail back there is another Vim Tools. I love them things, but my goodness, they are expensive. The Westling racks, on the other hand, not so bad. All of the impact stuff is all Sun-X, and all of the chrome are Proto. As you can see, I don't have near as much SAE as I do metric because, well, we all know how that's going. The one thing metric did win out on is vehicles, it seems. I have some of my longer extensions in here. Longer, and I pull out a 1-inch. The 3/8 extensions, I should have said, are all here. All I did was put a rubber grommet in the holes where the screwdrivers are supposed to go. Keeps them from falling through. This is a, what is this? An Astro Tools hose clamp remover. Pretty cool. I've got a speed wrench back here, an old snap-on ratchet, 36 tooth, but hey, it's a snap-on, so it should be in the Sunday go-to-meeting box, right? Over here, those are all Mayhew Dominators, probably the best pry bars you can get. And besides, they make them for everybody else who just puts their name on them anyhow. Got my M12 ratchet up here, just some nonsense really. And I know if you're a mechanic, this is looking mighty sparse, but it suits the purpose anyway. First drawer is wrenches. I have the, everybody calls them mountain wrenches. I've got the Carlisle version. Very handy as long as you got room for the length of those things, but I like a reversible ratcheting wrench, and these have that little, well, I mean, there's a million videos about these wrenches on YouTube, but anyway, I got the Carlisle version. These are Craftsman Pros from back in the good old days, and I didn't have the larger sizes, so after doing a little bit of searching, I found out that Armstrong is who actually made those wrenches for Sears. So I found some individual Armstrongs to kind of round that out to some bigger stuff. Down here, I've got some Mac Tools reversible ratcheting. Very nice wrenches. Precision Torque. Out in the shop, my reversible ratcheting are all old Craftsman Pros. For the SAE side, I got some Blackhawks back whenever they were still US made. They're satin, but I really like those wrenches. And these wrench holders are kind of little cheapies, but you can sure stack some wrenches in a drawer. I mean, I got all kind of room here left. I just don't have enough money to fill it up. Second drawer, screwdrivers, bits, you know, that sort of thing. Panel pullers, those are all Vessel. Screwdrivers are Vessel. Out in the garage, I've got Weira German ones, but man, I think the Japanese figured out the screwdrivers because I love them screwdrivers. Some Icon picks. Some old Snap-on mini Torx, Harbor Freight Special extractors, old Sears Craftsman extractors, Bondus Allen wrenches and Torx, Mac Tools panel pop tool, some bits, Weha, or I should say Viha, because everybody will say that's how you say this. Because yeah, it's true. In Germany, the W sounds like a V. However, are the same people bitching about how I say Weha, calling their BMWs a BMW? Because that's what they say in Germany, right? Or how about an FW, Volkswagen? That's what I thought. Got some, let's see, that's an old Facom impact screwdriver, Harbor Freight dead blows, Craftsman ball peen. This little thing's cool if you ain't ever seen one. It tension zip ties and cuts them off at the same time. Pretty sharp. Let me see. I don't remember who made it. Thomas and Betts. And there's the part number. Probably got as much money in Nipex pliers here. And yeah, I said Nipex, not Knipex. Don't make me go back to the W and V thing. But I got as much money in Nipex pliers as I do the box, basically. These are very cool crimpers from Carlisle, basically a copy or maybe same factory as the Snap-ons. My really old Facom pliers are still hanging in there. Some channel locks. Everything in here for the vice grips are all Bremen from Harbor Freight. After watching some reviews, I decided I wasn't gonna pay for the latest, greatest American ones on those because they are ridiculously expensive. Some channel lock oil filter pliers, Sterrett pin punches, some Facom pin punches. Down here's kind of a catch-all. Got my multimeter, some more old school Craftsman extractors, blades for the Sawzall, electrical stuff, what the hell, Tessa tape, electrical tape, a remote for my TV that never gets turned on, sockets that overran my rails. Down here, I got a bunch of torque wrenches from the cheapest to the most expensive. There's a Snap-on Dad gave me, a couple of Pittsburghs I paid for, a Mac I got off eBay probably 20 years ago. I don't remember. I know this one was an expensive little fella, but I don't remember who the heck made it. She's oldie though. That's mainly for inch pounds for like scope rings and stuff like that. This Mac torque driver is absolutely for scope rings and gun stuff. That's a good driver right there. I've got a cheapo Harbor Freight wind back tool because I drive old junk and was doing the brakes on the daughter's car. Could not figure out why in the world I couldn't get the rear pads to compress. So a little Google search led me to find out that I needed one of those. That thing works pretty good too, cheap. Again, I'm not a pro, so I don't need a Snap-on version. Bottom drawer is all stuff for detailing cars. Got my flex polisher, my Porter cable polisher, which I use mainly for upholstery, pads, junk stuff. On the side, again, Harbor Freight glove holder thing with Harbor Freight gloves in it. This box is set up for power. I don't have any need for that, but you can put a power strip in here. And this is a JSC 770. There is a newer version, 773. I really didn't see any difference, but nevertheless, I can vouch for that box. I mean, in this environment, that thing would last several lifetimes because I'm the only one that messes with it and it doesn't get moved. But anyway, there's my video for today. Y'all go check out Outdoors for Life, which is my grandson Skyler's channel. He just started it and he's gonna catch me and subscribers, so I don't know why I'm telling you to go visit him. He should be telling people to come visit me. And I'll try to get some more content up a little bit more often. But that's it for today. Thanks, y'all.